1 or 2 minutes of your time to mention one hadith to you about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This hadith is mentioned in Bukhari also. The reason why I choose this hadith is because it tells you how far we have come in terms of our own khataya, in terms of our own sins, and it gives you two people. This hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam talks about two people, and it's easy for us to decide which one of those individuals we are. It's easy for us to put ourselves in either one of those categories, and I leave that decision up to you to believe what category that you are in. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that a believer, a true mu'min, he sees his sins as if he was sitting on a mountain, and he's afraid that mountain will fall on top of him. That's how he sees his sins. That's how regretful he is. And a true mu'min sees his sins as if he were sitting on a mountain, and he feels that mountain is going to fall down, come crashing down on top of his head. That's how afraid he is. So he lives in his life in constant fear of that mountain crashing down upon his head. However, the wicked individual, the evil person who's indulged his entire life in sin, he sees his sins as a fly that lands on his nose and he just flicks it away, you know, without no care in the world. That's how his sins are. So they come and they go and he just flicks them away. Subhanallah, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we hear that the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, he was jawami al-kalim. The Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam was concise and yet comprehensive in meaning. His words, وَمَا يَمْتِقُ عَلِي الْحَوَى, the Quran says. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, he does not speak of his own desire. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى, except that it is a revelation, a wahi revealed to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at this beautiful narration. Now we know which one of those individuals we are. Have we indulged in sin so much that when we sin, we don't even know that we're sinning? So much so that we don't even believe we're sinning anymore. I met an individual who drinks alcohol. And he used to drink alcohol. May Allah forgive him for his sin. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him the ability to overcome that addiction. I mean, this individual, he drank alcohol so much that he began to feel that it's not a sin anymore. And when that happens to you, then know that you're from those wicked individuals who sees his sin as a fly that sits on top of his nose and he just brushes his hands over it and makes it go away and thinks it's going to go away, and yet that fly keeps coming back. Or are we from those individuals, or from that? Are we part of that group or that gathering that we see our sins like a mountain, always on top of our head, fearful that at any moment this mountain is going to come crashing down upon our head? That's the individual that we need to be. Our sins, that's how we need to feel, each and every one of us. And I say that to myself before I say it to you. Let's make ourselves from that gathering, from that group of people. Inshallah. The last comment that I'm going to make before I leave, and I did say I'm going to finish on time, but you know, that hardly ever happens. So I went back on my word again that I was supposed to finish at 2:30. Khair, the last thing is that, you know, in terms of repentance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we've established that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He forgives all sins. He forgives us no matter how, if our sins reach the sky, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us. But there's something that, you know, I'm sure most of you have come across quite recently, and you know, most of you are on social media and Facebook and Twitter and other things. You know, this culture now that is coming of exposing the sins of people, you know, exposing their sins. And this is something that we have to refrain from. You know, if you cover somebody's sins, or if you cover somebody's wrongdoing, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cover yours on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Don't we wish that on that day, those sins that we did in private, you know, when nobody knew of those sins except us, don't we want that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and put satr over us on that day, and He does not reveal them? You know, we all desire that. And if He want that, then cover other people's faults. Have usooluddin, have the best opinion about people. And in regards to the ulama, or those people who you see as shuyukh, and those people who you see as awliya, or friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those people who you see as honorable shuyukh, If they commit sins, then know that they do commit sins, they're not infallible. Your ulama, let me burst that bubble for you as well. Your ulama, your scholars, your shuyukhs, your peers, they're not infallible. They do commit sin. They do. You know the difference between us and those people are that when they commit sins, they're from amongst those people who see their sins as a mountain on top of their head. You know? That is going to fall down upon them any moment, so they constantly do dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask for that forgiveness. So if there are ulama or scholars who have done something wrong, who have committed sins, then do dua for those people instead of exposing their sins. Pray for them every week when you come to the gathering of hope. Pray for every single individual who's committed sins that week, including yourself. You know, a selfish dua is the one that is made for oneself. A man, a Bedouin, came to the mosque of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he says that, "Oh Allah," he came into the mosque and said, "Oh Allah, forgive me and Muhammad, have mercy upon me and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and nobody else." Ya Allah, forgive me and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and nobody else. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam came to him and said, "No, don't make that dua. May Allah forgive you, may Allah forgive me and everybody else." That's the dua that we need to make. That's not a selfish dua. That's our dua that we need to make. Whenever we seek repentance for ourselves, we seek forgiveness for our families, we seek forgiveness for our loved ones, we seek repentance and forgiveness for each and every individual of the Muslim Ummah, those of whom you haven't even met, still seek repentance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives them and gives them the ability to do tawbah and turn towards Him.